Hello friends, in numerical methods, we are going to introduce a procedure called Gauss-Seidel method. Gauss-Seidel method is another method that can be used to solve a system of linear algebraic equations. We have used a Jacobi iteration method in the previous video. So a system of linear algebraic equations can be represented as A times X equals B, where A is the square matrix of dimensions n by n. X is the solution vector of dimensions n by 1, and B is the right-hand side vector that has dimensions n by 1. So the algorithm for Gauss-Seidel method is given below. X of I comma k plus 1 equals X of I comma k plus R of I comma k over A of I comma I, where I varies from 1 to n. And R of I comma k equals B of I minus sigma j equals 1 to I minus 1 A of I comma j times X of j comma k plus 1 minus sigma j equals I to n A of I comma j times X of j comma k. Here I varies from 1 to n. N represents the number of rows and columns of the square matrix A. K represents the iteration number. K varies from 1 to n iter, where n underscore iter represents the total number of iterations. R represents the residual vector. And A represents the elements of the square matrix uppercase A, and B represents the elements of the right-hand side vector. So when we convert that set of equations from matrix form to equation form, we have equations represented as below. The residuals can be calculated as shown below. For example, R1 equals 100 times 4x1 plus x2 minus x4. So R1 basically represents the difference between the right-hand side and the left-hand side of the above equation. Since we are following an iterative procedure, we have to assume some initial values for x1, x2, and x4, etc., x3, x4, and x5. Because of that, the residuals R1, R2, R3, R4, they are not equal to zero initially. So the idea is to improve the residuals with our algorithm and bring the residuals to a very low value that is acceptable to our problem. So what is the difference between Gauss-Seidel method when compared with Jacobi iteration method? The procedures are very similar. In Jacobi iteration method, we compute all the values of x at all the rows, for example, x1 to x5, the first iteration, and we use them in the second iteration. For example, we find x1, 1 to x5, 1. Once all these values are computed, we use them in the next iteration level, x2, 1 to x2, 5. But in Gauss-Seidel method, we use, once these values are, of x's are computed, we use them right away into the equations. So the most recently computed values of x's are used for all subsequent computations. So what is the advantage of following this procedure? The convergence is generally quicker than Jacobi iteration method, and hence Gauss-Seidel method is generally considered more efficient than Jacobi iteration method. So going to MATLAB, we represent the matrix A is given here, and the right-hand side vector B is given here, and N is the number of rows or columns, and the number of iterations, the total number of iterations is set to 20 as before. So the algorithm provided here is similar to what we used for the Jacobi iteration method, but we had added a second term in the residual. So this second term takes care of the new values that are being computed, the new values of x. So when we run this program using Gauss-Seidel method, again this A matrix is given here and B vector is given here. We used the number of iterations used is 16, and the x values are computed here. So the final x values are given as 25 and 35.714, etc., after a good amount of convergence. When we used a MATLAB built-in function A / B, we can solve the same set of equations. So when we compare these values, they match very closely. So when we go back to the previous method we discussed, that is Jacobi iteration method, when we run this, we used total number of iterations as 19 compared with the total number of iterations that is used for the Gauss-Seidel method, which is 16. So based on that, we consider Gauss-Seidel method as generally more efficient than the Jacobi iteration method. To summarize, in this video we presented an iterative procedure called Gauss-Seidel method, which is similar to Jacobi iteration method but is considered more efficient. In the next video we can look at other iterative methods to solve a system of linear algebraic equations, such as successive relaxation methods, over relaxation methods, or SOR methods, that is based on Gauss-Seidel method. Thanks for watching the video. If you have any questions, please post it.